second topic, that is the additional three P's. So what are these three P's which are additional? Well, primarily talking, marketing mix talks about the four P's which we've already spoken about, being product, price, place and promotion, which is generally for the tangible industry. For the service industry, additional three P's, that is physical evidence, process and people, are also taken into consideration. Let's look into it into a little more detail as to what do we mean by each one of them. The first one being physical evidence. The evidence which shows that a service was performed, such as the delivery packaging for an item delivered by a delivery service or a scar left behind by a surgeon, all of this means the physical evidence. This reminds or reassures the consumer that the service did take place, either positively or negatively. Physical evidence is about where the service is being delivered from. The element of marketing mix will distinguish from company to its competitors. Physical evidence can be used to charge a premium price for a particular service and establish a positive experience. Customers will make judgment about the organization based on the physical evidence. For example, if you walk into a restaurant today, you expect a clean and a very friendly environment. If the restaurant is smelly or dirty, on the contrary, customers are likely to walk out even before the food has been served. Also, for example, in a theater, its physical setting and interior decoration plays a very important role, which forms a part of the physical evidence. The next P for the service industry is the process. Processes and systems within the organization that affect the execution of its service, such as job queuing or query handling. Banks that send out credit cards automatically when their customers' old ones has expired again, require an efficient process to identify the expiry dates and renewal. An efficient service that replaces the old credit cards will foster consumer loyalty and confidence in the company. All services need to be underpinned by clearly defined and efficient processes. This will avoid confusion and promote a consistent service. In other words, processes mean that everybody knows what to do and how to do and when to do. Let's take an example of a fast food restaurant over here, where you place the order in one counter with the coupon, the packaging happens in the second counter, and you collect your order in the third counter. The essential steps over here would be the first one, to identify all the logical steps for the particular process. Second one would be to sequentialize it in a logical manner, all the above steps. Third step would be to reduce the consumer interface or the consumer's interaction in the process. And fourth would be to automate the process as much as possible. Having said that, let's move to the last P, that is people. People are the most essential ingredient in the service provision. Recruiting and training the right staff is required to create a competitive advantage. Customers make judgment about the service provisions and delivery based on the people representing your organization. This is because people are one of the few elements of the service that customers can actually see and interact with. The employees that execute the service chiefly concerning the manner and skill in which they do. Having said that, let's once again look into the three P's and its key sub-elements which are part of it. Under process, which we are primarily talking about, is the flow of activities, the service script, that is the number of steps, and the customer involvement in the process. For the physical evidence, the key sub-elements being facility design, the service ambience, equipment, signage, employee dress, point of sale display and other tangibles, for example, business cards. And in the final category, that is the people, the key sub-elements being the recruitment of the employees, their training, their motivation, their reward system, teamwork, and the customer's education and training also. Having said that, we end the topic 2.